Blackstone presents Bigger Guns, More Trouble by Charles Tillman. This book is read by Chelsea Stevens. Prologue. French Quarter, New Orleans, Louisiana. Light flashed from the dimly lit alley as a shower of sparks fell to the dirty pavement. A bright light appeared in the shadows and expanded until a circular portal revealed two people.
Come on, Angelica. Move your skinny ass before they figure out we're gone, Randall snapped.
Ew, it stinks here. Why couldn't you take us to a park? Or better yet, a suite at La Pavilion or Windsor Court? Angelica Greymont whined.
Look, you insisted on coming, and I already told you we've got to cover our tracks. If your mother or my father finds out what we're doing, the repercussions won't be pleasant. Now let's go before someone sees us.
Randall closed the portal with a wave of his wand and caught Angelica's hand, dragging her toward the street.
Oh, Randall, you're hurting me, she squealed.
Hey, what the hell are you doing? Let the lady go and step away from her, a voice called from the alley's mouth.
Randall scowled at Angelica as a uniformed officer with his hand resting on the pistol at his side stepped toward them.
We're just leaving, Randall offered.
The officer unsnapped his pistol and gripped it.
Let the lady go and step away. Now.
I don't have time for this shit, Randall murmured as he released Angelica and stepped to the side.
He angled his body to one side where he could see the cop, but the officer couldn't see him palm the white ash wand he carried in a special pocket sewn into his sleeve.
She's had a bit to drink tonight and thought this was the way to our hotel, officer.
Randall smiled, hoping to defuse the situation.
Is that true, ma'am?
Yes, whatever he says, Angelica answered unsteadily.
I need to see some ID from both of you.
The officer's face hardened and he reached for the microphone clipped to his uniform.
Sure thing, officer.
Randall reached toward his back pocket with his left hand and brought the wand up with his right.
Globus glacium,
Randall murmured as he spun the wand counterclockwise. The officer went still as frost formed over his body. His mouth opened in a silent scream as thick ice encased him from head to toe.
A copsicle? That's cold.
Angelica giggled as Randall caught her hand and pulled her past the frozen statue.
That one's on you. Now shut up and let's get out of here before anybody else shows up, Randall growled.
Angelica took several stumbling steps when he jerked her hand, then caught up and walked by his side as they left the scene. A shapeless pile of refuse stirred in the shadows as the homeless vagrant who called the alley home stared in shock at what he saw. Chapter 1. Big Muddy Importers, Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Son of a bitch!
Matt yelled as a knife flew from the shadows above where he crouched and stuck into a rack of shelves, narrowly missing his head. He jerked back and realized his mistake when a bolt of energy hit him at chest level, flaring his shields and knocking him into a metal support beam. Luckily, the wards and charms worked into his heavy leather jacket saved him from anything more severe than having his breath knocked out. He rolled to his side with his wand extended as rapidly retreating footsteps and a high-pitched giggle let him know he'd flushed the bounty from hiding.
Cher, the little bastard's heading toward the back. Watch out, 'cause he's throwing knives.
A bright flash illuminated the dim warehouse, followed by an enraged scream and the sound of water running through the overhead pipes.
Motherfucker! Natalia shrieked. This shirt is silk, you troll-loving, ass-sucking shit stain!
Oh, this ain't good, Matt muttered.
Natalia seldom cursed, and experience taught him that bad things were about to happen when she did.
Cher, the bounty says he has to be breathing, or we don't get paid.
Oh, damn.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.